Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2316. How would you do this? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Gillen. It's a Sunday. It's 4 a.m. I'm starting today just like I start almost every day, where I go through emails and I look for some interesting Excel problem that I can solve. It's a great way to start the day. But I find that here in the darkness of Merritt Island at 4 a.m, sometimes I manage to just get trapped down a rabbit hole with some horrible solution. And so, today, Sunday, I want to bounce this problem off of you, and I want to hear how you would solve this. I'm sure there has to be something far easier than what I came up with. All right, so I get an email from someone who had been in one of my seminars, and they have the data that looks like this, and they say this data is coming. It's a summary from many sheets, right? And what they have here, they're showing me a sample of data with just 4 employees, and they want to twist that data into this table down here, right? So see these categories? Those appear along the left-hand side, and that employee name from G3 is going to get repeated here in column B. And Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. It's funny, the employee name, that 18 is actually the sum of these 4. I don't have formulas there, but it's working out everywhere that if I add up those 4 cells. So it's kind of weird that we're getting the employee total first and then Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. And this is weird. It's like I want to unpivot, but I don't want to unpivot every column. I want to unpivot chunks of columns. All right. Remember, it's 4 a.m. Now look, before I start, think about this. If this was your data, in fact, download the data, and I'll put a link down there in the YouTube description. How would you solve this? I don't want to cloud your thought process with the horrible set of steps I came up with. What would you do to twist that data at the top into the data at the bottom? Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this data. I'm not going to make it into a table because, you know, who knows, that might cause problems. I'm just going to name the range. So I choose the data and we'll call it ugly data. Great name for the data, right? And then data from table or range. And here we are in Power Query. All right, now automatically they promoted the headers and changed type. That's great. We're gonna let that go. I want to keep the category description along the left-hand side, and then unpivot everything else. And in fact, I think I'm only going to want to keep Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 if somehow I can manage to get that employee name out. Like, I don't need that total column. So I start here, transform, unpivot the other columns. All right, now look at this. This is interesting. So the columns that we're going across started out Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and then Q1 underscore 1, Q2 underscore 2, Q3 underscore 3, and it just keeps adding more column numbers, apparently because that must have happened here. Yeah. Okay, got it. Well, my next thought process is I want to break this column into 2 columns, the name in 1 column and the quarters in another column. But that underscore is really going to cause problems. So I choose that column, split column, by delimiter. Oh, they even got it at the leftmost delimiter. So the first underscore we find, click OK, and I have attribute 1, attribute 2. That's the underscore 1. I don't need that. I'll remove that and then rename this to be text value. All right, now it looks pretty simple here. If it's a length of 2, then it's a quarter. If it's not a length of 2, then it's an employee name. All right, so I want to basically, in Excel, this would be easy. Equal if the length of this is equal to 2, then move it over to another column. Otherwise, don't. But I have to tell you, I'm really bad at these functions in Power Query. So I'm going to create a custom column, and I'll call it length. And while it's the LEN function in Excel, here it's the text.length. text value. All right, no syntax errors have been detected. That's good. Let's click OK. There we are. Okay, now I need to say if this is 2, then I know it's a quarter. If it's more than 2, then it's a name, and I want to move that name over into a new column. And so the rule is going to be, if the length is greater than 2, then bring the name over here to a new column. Otherwise, put the word null in there. And where I'm headed, I know that I'm going to use fill down to copy those names down into the null cells. So, under add column, we're going to create a new conditional column. It's going to be called name. And we're going to say, if the length is greater than 2, then I want to bring the text value over. All right, to get text value, you have to open that little drop down, select column, and say text value. Otherwise, let's see, how am I going to put the word null in there? I'm just hoping that I can put null. Click OK. Oh, perfect. It actually gave me null values. That's beautiful. Now, from there, I have the name separated out, transform, fill down. All right. Yeah, that's good. That's some success right there, because now I have the employee name on every single row. All right, so we'll move that name over here to the left of text value. And remember these employee totals here, where it says employee 1, employee 2, employee 3. Those are totals that I'll need. That 18 is 14 plus 4 plus 0 plus 0. Don't need that anymore. So we'll filter this, and I literally just want to keep Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. All the other employee names, I'm sure there's going to be a lot more of them, will go away. Good. All right, and then I want to get rid of department totals in this column. And this is tricky. While here in text value, I was able to choose the 4 things I wanted to keep, here I want to be careful to choose the thing I want to get rid of. So I'm going to use the text filters, does not equal, and here you don't need quotes, department total, click OK. All right, so there's our description, there's our names. There's our quarters and the value. We don't need length. That was a temporary column. I'll remove that. All right. And while I use Unpivot a lot in Power Query, I've never actually done the opposite, which is to pivot the column. I need to take these quarters and make them go across. So here it is right here on the Transform tab, Pivot Column. I'm going to choose that's the column I want to pivot. We say Pivot Column. Use the names in column text value to create new columns, and the values column is going to be value. Advanced options. Oh, good. So it's automatically choosing to sum. I guess if we needed, you could do any of the other standard calculations there. Click OK. Hey, all right. Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. It seems a little screwed up that the data has been. Like employee 1 is not all together. That's easy to fix though. On the Home tab, A to Z to sort. So now we have employee 1 and then the various items within employee 1. Boy, they're not in order anymore, and I can't sort them because they, you know, I can't sort by a custom list. All right, we're just going to let that go. Last thing we have to do out here on the far right-hand side is add a column that sums Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. So add a column, add a custom column, we'll call it total, and then equal Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. Click OK. All right, and then home, close and load. All right, so there's employee 1, the various categories for employee 1, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, totaling up to 56. All right, so I think that's it. But wow, there has to be some easier, simpler way. All right, so if you have one, down in the YouTube comments, tell me how to do this. I don't know, you know, is there a prize here, bragging rights, an Excel guru patch, who knows. This is a brand new feature. Just let's see if we can have some fun with this one. Buy the book. Well, hey, let's talk about Ken Puls' book, M is for Data Monkey. Everything I learned about Power Query, I learned from here, which is great if my solution is the best solution, but I guess it's horrible if there's some just blindingly easy thing that I can't see. It's Sunday. Usually, I'm giving you tips. Today, I'm asking you for tips. Please, subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.